my phonograph, my Audio Technica. I've still got the box, putting it in the box, packing it up. Here's one of the boxes for my telescope. And here's some of the other boxes for the scope. One's for the tripod, the other's for the telescope. And I'm decided about 2 weeks ago that I would start with getting all my stuff out of this house and then worry about Mom and my stepfather. I decided to make a little vlog about the challenges I'm facing now. And I'm going to have a little problem with light here because the sun is pretty bright today. We're having a good sunny day. So if you'll pardon me, I'll just cut off some of the sun and refocus. There we are. Now, this table is actually an interesting vignette of reality. There is, of course, the mountain sheep. I found another one of them. And there, does that look better? Yeah, you can see it a little better. And then there's a nice liberal Bible and a potion and some books I'm reading. I'm just gonna sit here and tell you some of the challenges I've been facing. A little extra light. Now, I've always known that sooner or later I would have to leave, and that this would be only a temporary home for me, but I was not aware that this temporary situation would go on for 11 years. And then towards the end, as we got to 10 years, I thought, well, maybe she'll live to be 100. But she didn't make it past 97 and a half, 97 years, 6 months, 2 weeks. Yeah. 2.5 weeks. Yeah. So I had planned to just go back to Tijuana and live in the little studio I've continued to rent for the last 11 years, $170 a month. I'd lived there for about 3 years, I think it was, I lived there. A year before that, just a block away in Otay. For a while, I was keeping both apartments, Maria Teresa's and mine, but her landlady said somebody wanted to move in, so a little over a year ago, I stopped paying rent. That was expensive. That was $350 for a three-bedroom upstairs flat. The whole second floor of the house, three bedrooms, one bathroom, kitchen, dining space, and a living room area. It was an open space, you know, living, dining, and kitchen. And there was a very beautiful front porch that Terry had plants on. But I don't have that anymore. I let it go more than a year ago. However, I had kept my little room, my studio, great big room with built-in cabinets and a good-sized bathroom.
And I had lived in that room for 3 years. And I've kept it ever since, and I haven't been back in about 9 years. But the landlord tells me it's still there. It got broken into once, so I don't know what kind of mess I'll find. But I'll drink to the hope that I find some of my things there. So do I go to Mexico, or do I stay here? Now, for my health insurance, which is very important because I'm getting old and I'm going to die, and I need to have insurance to help pay for my needs and my final hospice and that stuff. A few years down the road, God willing, and the creek don't rise. Inshallah. So I have to have an address, a legal address, my legal address. I have to be a legal resident in California. Well, then came along my brother who wants to sell the house that we lived in when we were children, that my mother kept. It's in a very, very good neighborhood, as in not cheap. The house itself is small. For the neighborhood. Up on the hillside up above us, there are big houses with 4 and 5 and 6 bedrooms and 4 or 5 bedrooms and bathrooms, and they're big ones up there. $1 million houses, $2 million houses. And a lot of in the upper 600, 700, 800,000. It's an interesting neighborhood that our house was in. My parents hit a little gold mine buying their little American dream house with 3 bedrooms and 2 baths, and down in the canyon below this mountain where all the rich people live. I remember people used to think I was rich, and what could I say? Well, no, but my parents both work and they're professionals, and we do have a nice house. We often bought used cars. I remember we bought the first new car we bought in a long time was in 1962. We'd had 3 used cars before that. And then we bought a brand new Ford Fairlane in 1962. Well, since then, the parents, both my father and my mother, and after my father died, my mother and my stepfather, have tended to buy used cars, although they're very nice ones. The one I'm driving now that she had, that my stepfather bought for my mother, oh, good heavens, it must have been about 5 years before he died. Anyway, it's a 1999, and it was about 5 years old when he bought it. He paid $35,000, or at least that's what I was told. Maybe that was bragging. It was a used car. It was 4 or 5 years old at the time. And we still have it, or I should say I still have it, because I'm the only one now still here, still driving. My mom drove it. My stepfather stopped driving about the time that he bought her that car, and she drove it up until a year or two after he died, and then she asked me to take over all the driving. By then I'd been living with her. She didn't feel right about driving anymore. And so I'm driving this car that's worth, if it was in perfect shape, cosmetically. The engine is in good shape, so far as I know. We've got to go in to do an oil change within a couple months, it's about time to do that. But we've always kept up on top. We changed the timing belt at around 90,000 miles when it had to be changed. That was expensive. The car is a Lexus. It's an SUV. It's basically one of those Toyota SUVs from the 90s, but upgraded with some luxury touches. It's a 1999 Lexus LX 470. And the poor little thing only gets, if I drive carefully, 12 or 13 miles to the gallon. It's horrifying, which is good that I don't drive very much. I figured out my budget before things changed around, and I suddenly found I might have a little more money if we sell the house. But I figured out my budget based on rent from the house and this and that and the other, and if I just lived on the road, I could afford to drive 25 miles a day. So I'd have to go somewhere and camp there for 3 or 4 nights, somewhere free, like Anza Borrego Desert. Oh, what if it's summer and I'm burning up? Nope, won't go there. Go to far up in the mountains, up in Northern California or Colorado. That's where I want to go camping in the summer when it's 1,000 degrees in the desert. And then in the winter, you come back to the desert where it's only 70 or 80 instead of freezing. Sometimes it gets cold at night, though. I'll tell you, you have to stay warm. All of these dreams pass through my head. The dream of going back to Tijuana to living in my little studio, which is warm enough, and it was hot in the summer, but not that bad because it's not far from the sea. A lot better than the desert. Oh, oh yes. So that, or camping on the road, but I have to have a legal address in San Diego. So this was toying around in my mind, how do I resolve the fact I may have to have a place to live, and I don't have that kind of money. Well, then comes my brother, a few weeks after Mom died, telling me he wants to sell the house. He doesn't want the rent every month. He wants to sell the house and take his half. So all of a sudden, I was faced with a possibility that I might have my half in money, and maybe I should buy a condo or a manufactured home in a park. That is to say, I would become a trailer court man. Just imagine that. Trailer trash. Lots of my people live in trailer courts. My great aunt, my great grandmother's baby sister, lived in one around about here. She came to San Diego before my grandmother did. And I remember as a child going to see her. She lived in a God-honest trailer, in a little trailer court. And now, let's see, one of my stepbrothers and a dear friend of the family, a lady we all admire, both live in the same park, manufactured home park. But their rent's too high. They pay a high rent, like $1,000 a month. They own their little houses, their manufactured homes. And they're not so little. They're 2 and 3 bedrooms. Some of these are these double-wide houses. Man. So I could buy one of those, but I don't want to live with my stepbrother and the friend of the family because it's too hot out there. They live out in El Cajon, 20 miles from the sea, and it's regularly 90 and 100 degrees in the summer. Now, it's not too far from the house in La Mesa where my brother and I grew up, and I remember as a child swearing, I'm not going to live here. It's too hot in the summer. It was too hot. And even here, halfway to the sea from there, here in this neighborhood, it gets a little warm. It's starting to get warm now. The time is coming. July, August, September, it's going to be warm. 90 degrees. But that's a hell of a lot better than 100. And then I've been looking all over San Diego County, one eye on the climate, and one eye on the prices, because I can't afford to pay a lot of money. I've only got half of a sale of a house. Fortunately, the house is all paid for, so my brother and I basically get all of the money, minus 8 or 9% expenses of selling a house. So I would be able to buy a little condo or a manufactured home somewhere, and so I'm keeping an eye on how much do these home parks charge, because they all charge rent. Condos charge homeowner association $300, $400 a month. The manufactured home parks or trailer courts charge anywhere from $500 to $2,000 a month rent just to live in there. Their beautiful park. And then when I look at all those numbers going by, I keep thinking, there's got to be some way I can go live in Mexico. There's got to be some way I can go live in Mexico. And that, my friends, is what is bedeviling my mind these days. 3 months after my beloved mama left this house and left this life. God bless you, Mother, and all of the ancestors with you, and all of us living family still here. God bless us all, everyone.